So please relax and prepare for takeoff.
The Iron Fresh sounds have become synonymous with scratching. They've been used in over 2,400 songs according to whosampled.com. Instagram is saturated with DJs freestyling with the samples. Almost every battle record released these days has one or both of the sounds on them. But how did we get here? And has it always been this way? In this video, I'm going to take a closer look at the history of the samples, who popularized them, and why they've become the staple scratch sounds used today. The first person to use the samples was Grandmixer DXT, then known as Grandmixer DST. The scratches were recorded for the 1983 Herbie Hancock single, Rocket, a seminal record which inspired many of the next generation of DJs to begin scratching. The most famous performance of the song was for the 1984 Grammys. That year, the Grammy telecast had 43.8 million viewers, its highest ratings ever. DJs including Qbert, Mixmaster Mike, Babu and Cut Chemist have all mentioned DXT as an inspiration. The fact that so many DJs were inspired by this song has obviously had a lasting effect. DXT used both parts of the sample in Rocket. Now let's dig into where the sample was from originally. Change the Beat is a song written and recorded by Fab Five Freddy. It was recorded at OAO Studio in Brooklyn, New York, and released as a 12-inch single on the Celluloid label in 1982. The side A version is 7 minutes 40 seconds long and features Fab Five Freddy rapping in both English and French. He also performs the chorus of the song, utilising a Roland SVC-350 vocoder with a white noise carrier to achieve a gritty, robotic effect. It's the side B version that we're interested in. At the end appears the infamous phrase, spoken through the same vocoder. According to Dave Tompkins in his book, How to Wreck a Nice Beach, the vocoder from World War II to hip-hop, The Machine Speaks. The infinitely sampled words came from a man named Roger Trilling. Trilling was the manager of Bill Laswell, musician and producer of the record. Trilling was imitating a record executive who would exclaim, "This stuff is really fresh," whenever he heard a song he liked. The sample then is an imitation of this executive by Roger Trilling and spoken through a vocoder. If that's where the sample comes from, why has it remained part of the scratch vocabulary for such a long time? We touched on Rocket earlier, which obviously had a lasting effect, but there's more to it than that.
DST was the first one to use that sound. You can gauge a DJ's skills by when they use that sound. It's kind of like if you can gauge a guitarist's skill, if they just use a plain acoustic guitar and see what they could do with it, you know. So this is like the plain sound right here. Or this one.
That was DJ Qbert, poster boy of the scratch community, talking about the R and Fresh samples. Qbert calls the samples the plain sounds. This got me thinking about the characteristics of the sounds, and why of all the millions of samples available to us, these two sounds that are from the very same record have become the staple for scratching. A useful way to describe the characteristics of a sound is using ADSR envelopes. ADSR stands for Attack, Decay, Sustain and Release. ADSR envelopes are commonly found on synthesizers. The concept can be used to describe all sound, however. This infographic by Lander helps describe the stages a sound goes through when a key on a synth is pressed. When you first press a key, the attack refers to the time it takes your sound to go from silent to the loudest level. The decay time controls how long it takes for your sound to go from the initial peak of your attack to the sustain level. Sustain refers to the level during the main sequence of your sound. It's the level that your sound maintains when you hold a note. Release controls how long it takes your sound to return to silence after the key is released. A longer release time means a longer fade out. Let's take a look at some examples. This synth sound demonstrates a fast attack, fast decay, long sustain, and medium release. This kick drum can be said to have just a fast attack and a fast release, as you cannot really hold down a drum. This other synth note demonstrates a slow attack, but then ends abruptly with a fast release. The R sound has a fast attack, similar to a kick drum, but then a slow release. The Fresh sound is made up of two separate parts, but can also be viewed in a very similar way.
What's this?
I've also thrown in a two-part vocal sample, which demonstrates a fast attack and a fast release. I believe the fast attack and slow release characteristics of the R and Fresh are the reason why these sounds are so popular for scratching. Different scratch techniques work better with certain samples more than others. Take a chirp, for example. Traditionally, this technique focuses at the very beginning of a sample only. A sharp attack is required to get the most out of this technique. Transformers, on the other hand, are easier with a long, drawn-out sample or a slow release. This gives you room to get in enough different clicks to be satisfying. You can complete pretty much any kind of scratch you can think of with the RFresh samples. They are very forgiving and feel comfortable for the majority of scratches. As mentioned before, they have also both been run through a vocoder with a white noise carrier. So what does this mean? White noise is a random signal having equal intensity across the frequency range. We're probably all familiar with what it sounds like, but this is what it looks like when put into a spectral analyzer. Let's take our sample from before and pass it through the vocoder with a white noise carrier.
What's this? 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 What's this?
What's this? What's this? What's this? Is it because these samples have been run through a vocoder that makes them so popular? It's hard to say, but as we were looking at the characteristics of the sounds, I felt this was a necessary demonstration. It can be hard to draw any conclusions when you look at the ethnomusicology of any phenomena like this. I can relate this back to my own experiences, however. When I first started scratching, I looked up to my idols and wanted to do what they did. If I had the same sample as they did, I could compare my sound to theirs to know if I was doing the right techniques. I used to study DJ Qbert, and he was using the RFresh samples. Likewise, as we saw earlier, he looked up to Grand Mixer DST and wanted to emulate him. The turntable is an amazingly versatile instrument that can be changed just by changing the record you decide to put on it. Scratching is often compared to talking to each other, and when you're talking, it really helps if you talk in the same language. I think that's the main reason that RFresh have been around for such a long time, and will probably be here to stay for quite a lot longer. That's it. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. That took me absolutely ages to finish. That's what I've not posted in a little while, but I just really wanted to push my boundaries in terms of editing and motion graphics and things like that and kind of do more of a video essay type thing. I hope you can appreciate that and drop a like if you think I've earned it. If not, you know, feel free to drop a dislike or even two and they'll cancel each other out and we can pretend it never happened. I still hate asking for this bit, but please subscribe and hit the notification bell if you can. That'd be amazing. Let me know your thoughts on the video and if you agree or not. Obviously, some of it's my own opinion and just my own findings, so you know, you may or may not agree. But yeah, it'd be cool to find out what you think. I'm always enjoying reading the comments and seeing how people are, you know, think about things differently. And the other thing I wanted to bring up is I've hit my goal. So yeah, look here. Goal number one, 1,000 subscribers on YouTube in 2020. And we're 6 months in and we've hit it, which is absolutely amazing. Thank you guys. I guess COVID sort of helped because it's given me the time and also just there's been lots of people viewing YouTube videos and things like that, which give me lots of encouragement, but I don't really care about that stuff. Just the fact that I've hit it is amazing because I never really hit my goals. And like, yeah, I'm just super happy that I've already reached that. This is a little gift my wife got me as a congratulations, and I guess it's just, you know, to stop her, I can put it up and it'll stop her walking in and me being like, shut up, I'm filming. Thanks again for watching and see you on the next one. Bye.